So, welcome to the
right.
third episode of the Nidha Firdaus show. So, today I
Yes.
have a very special guest with us and a very dear friend of mine, all the way from Nigeria. So, he's
Yes.
basically a brand identity designer and a strategy developer. He is
Yeah.
passionate about helping small and medium sized businesses build brand sustainability and relevance. So, yeah, welcome to the show. Ayomide, how are you? Did I miss something?
I'm fine. I'm fine. Yeah. It's great to meet you, Nida. I don't know if I pronounced you very well. And it's really a privilege for me to be here to talk to people about branding because it's one of my best topic ever, and I choose it as a result of passion.
So my first question to you is, you know,
Yeah.
like, just tell me about yourself. Like, I just want to know your journey, your educational background. Like, when did you start?
Okay.
In a short way.
All right. So I actually studied physics in school. I graduated
Okay.
about 2 years ago. I studied physics in the university, and actually, I developed passion in designs for about 5 years ago right now. So I started as a graphic designer, of which I still do up to now. And I, you know, passion leads us to a lot of places. So majorly, I don't know if it happens over there in India or other part of the world, you find yourself doing something because people are doing it or because somebody actually told you about it and it looks so cool and interesting, or because so. But actually, I found myself studying physics because I was passionate about physics. I love science, and I chose physics as a
Okay.
course, and I did well in it anyway. But nevertheless, I had something inside of me personally. I was very passionate about designs. I drew as a
Okay.
young boy, and I started, you know, drawing on canvas and paper sheet and legs. And I was like, and they started talking about brand strategy, brand, blah, 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 like that. And I was like, ah, what is this? I'm really interested in this. And I met the likes of, you know, Chris Du, the likes of David Tallers, and a lot of people like that. So they brought the idea of brand strategy. And okay, that's where it all started from. And I started learning strategies. And I discovered that it wasn't just about designing alone. Before you can design, there must have been some strategy. So I learned that design is a communication. So it's not just something you just want to do. So you have to communicate. And before you can communicate effectively to people, there must be a strategy for communication, because we are interacting with people's mind. We are interacting with people of different calibers. So how do you communicate with different people in different communities? So I discovered that, okay, it has to start like that. So my graphic designer to speak in different dimensions to different people so that I can effectively communicate with them. And so it entered like that. So that's how I started. So, and currently I'm working as a brand developer for a design agency in Lagos. And I'm also that lead designer and communication lead currently right now. So that is how it all started. And the journey is becoming greater and greater. So,
since you are a brand consultant, so my
yeah.
second question would be, Key, what is the definition of brand? What is the definition of brand to you? Why is it important?
Right.
And also tell me,
right.
Key, how it has evolved over years.
All right. So now, brand is a perception. Now, I would love to clearly state this, that one of the mistakes that a lot of people have made is determining a brand is not your logo. A brand is not your logo, and it will never be your logo. A brand is not your flyer. A brand is not your company's name. I want to clear that very well again. A brand is not your company's name. A brand is what the people say about you, what they say about your business when you are not there. It was defined by someone like that. So a brand is a result of branding. I want to clear that very well now. So branding is a process of producing a brand. A brand is a perception. So if I should buy from you, at the end of the day, there is something there is an experience I get from buying from you. So it's either I love your product or I don't love your product. It's either I love the way you sold the product to me or I don't like it. It's either I love what is on the product package or I don't like it. So all these things communicate a brand. At the end of the day, people define your brand by what you do, you know, what you have done, how your sales, I don't know how I'm going to put this in English right now, how your sellers or your salespeople were able to communicate your brand to the people. You know, I can sell to you, and at the end of the day, I didn't position myself rightly in your presence because I don't know what exactly the values of my organization is, and I just told you something else entirely. And by that, I'm defining a particular brand to a people. So a brand is an experience. It is a perception. It is what the people perceive about you, what they perceive about your products, what they perceive about what you sell, what they perceive about what you do. So a brand is never your logo. A brand is never your designs. So it's much more than that. I think I'm able to explain that correctly. So that is actually a brand is.
So I just understood, I learned something new today. The brand is not your logo. Brand is only what people think about you. Right?
Yeah.
So yeah, perfect, perfect. Very well explained. So my next question would be, like, people say that branding is a costly endeavor. So according to you, a person who is a small business owner, okay, so with not a lot of funding, okay, so can he build a brand for themselves or is it not possible at all?
All right. So actually, branding is awesome. Now, but one thing I want us to know is that I've had a lot of people that want to brand themselves. They want to do a DIY branding, you know, do-it-yourself branding. So that has made branding possible for everyone to do it on their own. But an advice I always give people is this. Don't just go straight to branding on your own. Now, if you know where you are going to, like for every good brand or for every good businesses that wants to go out there, you must know where exactly you are going to. You must know what you want to do. You must know the purpose of your business. You must know the mission. You must know the vision and where exactly you want to reach. So if you want to compete with the big guys out there, then branding will be costly for you. And it is a sacrifice because it's worth the money. At the end of the day, you gain something different. You receive something different from other businesses out there. So it is how you want to be unique. It is how you want to be differentiated from other businesses. If you choose to do it yourself, then you can find yourself in the midst of other do-it-yourself branding out there. So if you want to pay for it, definitely you'll be so different. And this is an advice I always ask. I will always ask for small businesses. If you know you don't have enough money for branding, always seek a brand consultant. Always seek a brand consultant. A brand consultant are in the good place to tell you what to do. How they can effectively manage your small money, the little money you have for your business or something. They know the big prices. They know the small ones. They know what to do. Just their own goal is to ensure that you are well branded, is that people perceive your business rightly and you sell correctly to the people. As long, no matter how much you have and no matter how costly branding is, the truth of the matter is that branding is quite expensive. But now there are a lot of people, there are a lot of tools out there that has made branding very, very easy. So you can actually utilize any of these tools for yourself, but you must have gained a level of expertise. For example, Canva. Now, Canva is a great branding tool. I think you know that very well. Yeah. Uh-huh. So there are a lot of tutorials out there. There are a lot of tutorials out there that helps you use Canva effectively. Why? You must not just use Canva straight up. You must know what your brand colors are. Maintain consistency with your brand colors and ensure that you keep using it up in this app. So it is not just for you to just do it anyhow. You must learn before you take up any branding tools. So most importantly, seek a brand consultant and he or she will teach you what exactly you are supposed to do and how to manage your resources. And if you have the money, come on, go for branding. Just do it. So knowing fully well that you want to go out there, you want to become one of the best, businesses out there in the world, then you need to spend the money. You need to help seek design agencies that can help you to create strong brand strategy and also an identity that your customers, your potential customers and your current customers can relate with, and also sell outside on your own behalf. Because when your business is well perceived, your customers will sell you off. Because our best mouthpiece is our customers. They are the ones that do the selling. They say if it is bad, they tell the people that it is bad. When it is good, they tell the people that it is good. So the experience is very essential. So this is one advice I do give for those that want to do branding themselves. So branding can be quite expensive, but yet not as expensive as you not going into it. Very important.
Perfect, perfect, perfect. So, okay. So my next question is my personal favorite. I just want to know, is there any particular framework which, people need to keep in mind when they are building a brand from scratch?
Okay. There are frameworks. There are a lot of frameworks for branding, because when you go online, you see a lot of frameworks. and you see a lot of things you are supposed to do. But the truth of the matter is that not every one of us can get it done by ourselves. And but I will just share a little I'll just divide the framework into five, if I will be correct, into five that are very essential for small businesses to do right now. So if you will be doing it yourself, and if you build a brand by yourself. So a framework is more or less like a strategy, a plan to build your brand. So the first thing is that you must have a business strategy. That one is very essential. Your business strategy. What exactly is your business model? Yeah, so what is your business all about? What would your business be doing? Who are you? Who exactly are you producing a product for?
Exactly.
What are your services all about? Yes. So it's all in the business strategy. Then from there, we now move into the part of the target audience. Now, before we go into the target audience, I want this to be done. You must ensure your brand purpose, your brand missions, and your brand values. Now, brand purpose. Okay, let me go back. There's something that we call brand essence. Brand essence. Are you listening to me now? Brand essence is why you are doing what you are doing. Yes. Many businesses have not gotten the clarity of why they are doing what they are doing. Let me tell you this. Your business, the purpose of a business is not just to make profit. The purpose of a business is to communicate value.
Exactly.
Any brand you see right now doing well is a brand that constantly communicate value to the people. They care about what people the problems they are solving with their with their businesses. I don't know if you get what I'm trying to say right now. So your brand essence is why you are doing what you are doing. So you must define your brand essence very, very well. It must be clearly stated out. Why exactly am I doing what I'm doing? Why exactly is this business existing? So this question, the answer to this question brings a lot of things in mind. It brings a lot of things in mind. It brings a lot of, ways you can provide solutions to people when you know why. So like a common quote I don't know if I can remember that quote right now, that when the purpose of a thing is not known, misuse or abuse is inevitable. So you misuse your business, you abuse it, and the people perceive it in a different dimension, and it crashes your business. And that's why so many businesses drown at the beginning of their business. So you must know why exactly you are doing what you are doing. That's the brand essence. And after the brand essence, then we move into the brand purpose. What is the purpose of a brand? That is the mission statement. What is the mission? How do you intend achieving this? You get what I'm trying to say now? What is your mission? This must be clearly stated down. And that's the other part of it. Then after that, who are the people that needs this? That is the target audience. Yes. Who are the people that needs this? Who are them? What is their demography? What is their psychography? How are they? Are they? What age range are they? Is it age 0 to 15? Is it age 18 to 45? And all those things are what we find here. So it's very essential that we know our brand. We know these things very, very well. Our brand target audience. One mistake I discovered that people make is that they want to sell to everybody. You can't sell to everybody. You should have an ideal customer. And you must see, branding requires patience. Branding requires patience. It's not something you can do within a week or two. You must find time. You must take time to develop it well, because you are introducing yourself to a new set of people, and they want to build trust within a certain period of time, and you can't start selling to them immediately. So that is one advice I do give people. Whenever you want to brand, just calm down, okay? Calm down, and you must know that it takes time. You must build trust first. So you must build trust with a certain people. So whenever you can have your target audience clearly stated, then you can sell to them. Because whenever I'm selling to someone that is not concerned about my business, then I'm wasting my time. So we must be able to, we must focus our energy on our target audience. Yes, so that is very, very important. What do they like? Where are they? Where do they stay? What is their age range? Like I think I've said that earlier, and this is very, very, very essential. So firstly, you must have your business model, then followed by knowing your brand essence, your brand purpose. That is the mission and vision statement. Then what? Your target audience. Then after knowing your target audience, you must also know that branding requires identity. Now, I would like to say this. We have three basic parts of branding. After you discover your brand your business model. Then after then that, we have your target audience. I think I said brand purpose, mission. Yes. Please pardon me. Then we must know, we must define our brand positioning. Now, this is where people get it wrong. Brand positioning is very essential. Don't rush into developing an identity without a brand not well positioned. I will repeat that again.
Absolutely.
Don't run into developing your brand identity. And under your brand identity, we have your logos, we have your flyers, we have, you know, your taglines, we have, you know, your imagery, your photography, and everything that, you know, that represents your brand out there. Let me tell you something. Brand is into different, two different aspects. We have the one underneath, and we have the one outside. I don't know how to put that in English right now. The one underneath is what the people cannot see. That's where we have the mission, the vision, the purpose, and a lot of things like that. But the one at the outside are the ones people can see. Let me say the one outside the iceberg. You know, the tip of the iceberg is what people can see. But what is underneath the iceberg is invisible to the people. So what is underneath the iceberg is what we call the positioning, the aspect of positioning, the aspect of declaring your mission, your vision statement, and the likes. So you must strongly build that. Trust me, when I don't know how to put this right now. If you don't have a strong under, the one on top cannot stand. I don't know if you get what I'm trying to say now. If you don't have a strong under, the one on top cannot stand. So your base must be very strong, and you must develop. Yeah. That is why you must develop your brand positioning very, very well. So when you have a strong, when you have a strong brand positioning, then outside there to be easy. So don't go into making yourself visible. Don't go into awareness if you have not well defined your brand under very well. So you must be well positioned. And one thing we do in positioning is brand differentiation. How are you unique? How do you communicate your uniqueness? Apple is a very unique brand. And trust me, we have a lot of small businesses that are unique. A lot of small businesses are unique. So you must be able to clearly state your uniqueness. So that is what brand positioning is all about. You must position your brand correctly so that people can perceive you strongly whenever they meet with you out there. I think you get what I'm trying to say now. So that is why brand positioning is the next level. So it helps you to, you know, it helps you to define your brand in a different way. Uniquely, you must be able to define your brand. What differentiates you? You are not like everybody. Every brand, every business has something unique to it or herself. Is it the ingredients you are using in that product that makes it different? Let the people know. This is what makes them remember you as a different kind of brand. Are you getting what I'm trying to say now? Okay. So brand positioning is very essential. Then after brand positioning, we move to brand identity development. And this is what the people interact with. Yeah, so this is what the people see. This is what they create experiences from. It goes from your logos, it goes from your brand merchandise, it goes to your videos and a lot of things like that. So you must be able to, you know, you must be able to create a very strong identity, and it starts from the logo. It starts from the logo. So a logo is not your brand. You don't just need a logo. I always tell people, you don't just need a logo, you need a brand. So before you can define your brand, you have to undergo branding. And logo creation is a part of branding. It's just a small part. It's one of the part of branding in the branding process. So you don't concentrate and stay on logo design alone. Then after your brand identity development, then you go into brand awareness or brand visibility. So it means that you are ready to sell to the people. So you are not confused. Mm-hmm. You can't confuse the customers anymore because you have done the assignment, the homework very, very well. So I would like to pause here, so I won't go too far. Thank you very much.
That's power pack.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, so just highlighting your USPs, I can say, which is very much important. So what I understood from your conversation is ki logo is not brand. Brand is what people think about you. And unless you position yourself, don't get into the visibility factor. Right?
Exactly. Yeah. You're right. Very right.
Okay. So tell me, what is brand story according to you, and why is it important in this 2020?
So brand story is very essential. All right, so 2020 is a very beautiful year. I don't know, I think you know that very well. The coronavirus and a lot of things that happened. In fact, you know, people got businesses drowned. A lot of people couldn't rise up again. Up to now, some businesses are still struggling to, you know, many staff sent away, and Meanwhile, some businesses are doing well. So how do you help people buy from you? That is the question in a very, very, very serious time like this. How do people buy from you? Because you're not the only one. So why should they buy from you? And one thing you must always know about branding is that the emotional value of branding is very essential. One thing that storytelling does is that it creates emotions. It creates emotions. I don't know if you've seen some adverts when you were younger and you want to watch it over and over again. The reason why you want to watch those adverts over and over again is because they you know, they build some stories that, oh God, I can't just ignore this. This is awesome. Because even if you're not interested in the goods, because of the way the story was being told, you want to buy it. So storytelling is a very, very great tool, one of the most important tools in branding. So every businesses that is well branded must be able to communicate that story in a unique way. And that's why we look for storytellers. So we must be ensure that our stories are well communicated. So it creates an emotional interaction with our customers. The reason why, a brand that communicates emotions to people, emotionally to people, sticks I don't know how to put it now. Customers sticks to brands that emotionally connect to people. So customers sticks to brands that emotionally connect to people. So storytelling has been one great tool that brand has used in this COVID-19 period. So even if you don't see the reason why you want to buy, storytelling makes you see it. There's a way. In fact, I was reading one book, and I'll be sharing the book with you for those that really want to grow their brand. And it was actually written by Seth Godin. It's titled The Fortune Cookie. Yeah, The Fortune Cookie Principle. Said a lot about storytelling. How storytelling, how it really, really, pushed away some popular brands. So storytelling is very essential. So it's a very important tool for us to leverage on when it comes to branding.
Perfect. Okay. So tell me, what is the relevance of social media and content marketing when it comes to this brand designing and, the brand development, I can say. So what is the relevance of social media and content marketing when it comes
to social media is a platform. I said something about three major parts of branding, than the positioning, the identity, and the visibility or the exposure. You expose your business in this digital age by social media. Now, the truth of the matter is that before social media came into existence, brand visibility has been existing. And there are other forms of traditional marketing. I think you know much about that very well, that have other, in terms of a lot of things that really makes people communicate with make our brand visible in the holding days before Facebook came into existence. Brand visibility has been in existence, but social media is a big platform right now. Businesses are having more returns on investments when they start embarking on social media very, very well. So content marketing is the way we communicate our brand to the people. So content marketing is very essential, because you can't sell through social media without content. Your content is what reveals your brand to the people. Your brand to the people. It's through content that people perceive you, and they perceive what they want to do. And it is through content that people decide to buy from you. Mm-hmm. I think I am correct with that. It is through content that people decide to buy from you. So every businesses must leverage on these channels. And one thing about social media is just that you don't sell on every social media channel. That's why I said you must first of all know your business imperative. You must know where you are going, who you are, and who exactly you are targeting. Your target audience determines your social media channel. Mm.
Yes.
You don't sell on Twitter when you are meant to be selling on Facebook, because you'll be frustrated. So that is one thing that many people don't understand. So you don't sell on Twitter when you're supposed to be selling on Facebook. It's not compulsory. You are all over. You can maintain Instagram. If Instagram is very good for your business and provides content that are very relevant for your customers and for your potential customers. So this is the essence of social media and content marketing. So social media is a platform to sell your content. And one thing I must make us understand, that different form of social media strategies, that aspect as a new business or as an emerging business where you need to build trust. So you need to educate people about what to sell. People need to build trust in you, because trust me, social media is another is a new normal, and people want to, you know, you must trust you before they can give you your money. Imagine you are buying from me in Nigeria, and you want to me to offer a service to you, and the first thing you think about is, ah, can I trust this guy? What if this guy takes my money away? And so you have to wait. You have to go through the customer journey of, you know, the awareness, the customer journey of the discovery, the customer journey of, you know, before you can make your decision. Are you getting at the hider journey? So you must do all those things before you can buy from me. Why? Because you need to build trust. Because we are selling through a platform that we are quite new to. So if it was people in India right now, definitely you know that, okay, I can locate our house and I'll collect my money. But you can't come to Nigeria. So you need to build trust with me before I can sell to you. And that is something about social media. So social media is a platform for content marketing. And every business must leverage on content marketing. And that is a new topic on its own. Why? Because you need content strategy to sell a business out there. All right, so let me, because of our time. Thank you.
Moving ahead to the next question. Tell me, what are the mistakes? What are the mistakes that you find in businesses or you have seen people doing when developing the brand strategy?
Okay. Yes. Yeah, so the mistakes that businesses do, I've discovered, and I would love to talk about this very well. one of the mistakes I discovered that many businesses do is this. They go straight into brand identity. Mm-hmm. The first thing, for example, I developed a business. I had a business idea. And in fact, I just wrote some things about it. And, you know, I felt like, okay, let me just go into it. The next thing I could remember is I need a logo. So they contact a graphic designer and tell them, please, I need a logo. Give me a logo that looks like this, that looks like that. And that is the wrong act. That's the wrong perspective. You are doing your business a serious harm. And that is why we must ensure that we recognize these things very, very well. Don't go straight into building a logo. Don't go straight into building a logo. You have to start by knowing your business imperative. Who are you? Where are you going to? What can you do? What are your customers' pain points? It starts from that part. So what are your customers' pain points? What problems are you solving to the people? Then you need to look for a brand consultant. Or if you can't find a design agency that can help you do the whole of the branding process, look for a brand consultant that can advise you on what exactly to do. That, okay, I have a business idea and I need branding. Branding is very essential for every business in this age. If you be leveraging on social media for your business, definitely branding must be one thing you want to do. So don't go straight into building your flyers, designing your flyers, or designing your logo, or do anything. You discover that it will communicate something wrong to the people. So take time, like I said earlier, in defining your brand identity. I mean, your brand positioning. Knowing who you are, knowing where you are going, then position your business rightly first. Have a documented statement of what you want to do, a documented statement of your target audience, so don't go straight into designing your logo. That is not the next thing. Yeah. That's not the next thing. That is the mistakes I see that so many businesses do. And they discover that, you know, they end up failing and they wonder why they're not meeting up with some competitors they're looking at. Those competitors didn't start the way you started. You have to make sure that you start at the right path, at the right place. Start from the first things first. It's very essential. So basically, I will just round it up like that this is a mistake so many businesses do. And another mistake is that they feel they can do it all by themselves. I'm not speaking like this because I'm a brand consultant or I just want to, have you work with me. But I need to tell you that branding requires strategy. Branding requires expertise. Branding requires a form of creative thinking. Everybody has his or her own areas of expertise and, you know, talent and gift. There are calibers of people that can make structured research. So they can help you to make research. You just pay them. Or they might not even, some can even do it a little bit free for you. And it might not be as expensive as you think it will be. But to save your business and to save, you know, the future of the dreams you have, you need to seek a brand consultant you need to seek brand strategy. Very, very important. So this is one mistake I discovered that people do. Don't do it all by yourself. Don't do your logos by yourself. I know there are a lot of digital tools out there that can help you do a logo in 5 minutes. Trust me, you won't be unique. If you really want to be unique, look for people that can help you create something unique that can't be found just anywhere. I guess now. So look for people that can help you design your brand messaging and a whole lot like that. Okay. Thank you very much.
I know it has a lot and more things to say, but still yes. We are telling in a crisp way. So you mean to say is a person with a good, experience can guide you perfectly. Simple. If I put it in a simple way. What advice would you like to give to an 18-year-old self?
Okay. All right. So, you guys took me back. All right. So, if I would advise my 18-year-old person, I would tell him that stick to your passion. Don't be distracted by what other people are doing. You are uniquely created for something different. And believe in yourself. Yes. Believe in yourself. Don't see, God created us in different ways. And we must be able to accept who we are and what we have been told to do. So if you have a passion in you, develop it. Don't wait for anybody. You are not too young to start. You are not too young to be great. If it's at 18 you discover your passion, stick to it. Another thing I would advise my 18-year-old is that look for people that can encourage you. Don't move with people that are lesser than you are. Seek people that, has a better understanding of what you want to be and how they can help you become it. Look for people that will help your mind grow. Don't look for people that are of the same level of mindset with you, because you will all think in the same dimension. So look for people that are thinking better than you are, irrespective of their age. I tell you that there are people that are 17, 16-year-old that has better mindsets than people of 18. So if it is such people that you have within you, in your community, stick to them. Why? Because you have to grow with them. Grow with them and both of you grows together. Whenever you want to go up, you have to stretch your hands up and somebody pulls you up. I don't know if you get what I'm saying now. So that is what I would advise my 18-year-old person. Stick to your passion. Start developing yourself and believe in yourself. Believe in yourself. Believe that you are limitless. And the sky is the starting point. Thank you very much.
So, to be very honest, this was my favorite answer till now. I mean, I totally agree with you. Follow your passion, believe in yourself. And the one thing which I really loved is whatever you said, you are the best version of yourself. No one is like you. Do not compare yourself with anyone. Because we usually think in that way, if that person is doing, why am I not doing? Because we all have a different destination, right? We all have a different destination. Simple as that. Yeah. So this was my personal favorite answer. So
thank you very much.
Moving ahead. My second last question to you would be, what is the one stereotype that you have about India and Indians?
Oh, wow. I love India. Oh, God. I love India. Oh, God. I need to come to India. Really?
Definitely.
I number one thing I love about India is their culture. I love the Indian culture, the dance culture of India. You guys are awesome. You are so unique. When I watch Indian movies, I want to enter the screen. I feel like, okay, one day I just have to be in India. So I love the culture in India. I love the dance part of that of them. Irrespective of how upgraded the world is going to, India has not stopped dancing. Dancing is not something that is extinct in India. It's not draining. It's going to get better and better. So when I watch your movies, I see these things and I'm like, wow, these guys are not relenting in these things. And, I see a lot of Indian movies I've watched. And, a lot of them, I love the personalities. I love the movie. I love the lessons that I see that you guys communicate. Trust me, in Nigeria, people watch more of Indian movies than Nigerian movies. I just want to tell you, yes. People watch a lot of, I've made research with my friends and discovered that majority of them have their laptops filled with Indian movies and Nigerian movies. Not because we don't really appreciate our movies, but there's something so unique about you guys, and this is what I can really say. And I've met a lot of Indian friends here on Instagram. They are very friendly. I mean, very, very friendly. And they stick to you. They check on you time and time, and I want to believe that it's like that for so many of them. So India, you guys are awesome, and I really would be looking forward to come over to India anytime soon, maybe to just teach brand strategy. Probably if you'd be inviting me to India.
That's crazy. Awesome. We would love to see you in India, and right now I'm feeling proud.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Do you love reading books?
Yeah, I love reading books very well. Yeah, I love reading books.
Oh, awesome. And, so, yes. What are the top three books? What are the top three books would you recommend to the audience to read?
All right. So, number one book is The Brand Gap. Go Get The Brand Gap by Martin Newmiller. You need to read that book. That book gives a lot of things about branding. It will help you as a personal brand and also as a business brand. As a small business, you can learn these things yourself. Because one of the things that there are so many, there will be some instances where you can't afford so many things, and you need to, you need to read them for yourself and know them for yourself. You can't always get the whole consultation because if you are consulting brand strategies about everything, then you spend a lot of money. So you need to read some books. So The Brand Gap is a very good one that you can read. Another thing again is The Purple Cow. The Purple Cow by Seth Godin is a very beautiful book about marketing and branding. It's really, Godin gave a lot of things about it. I don't know if you know the book. I don't know if you read about it. So The Purple Cow by Seth Godin, really, it's a very wonderful book you need to read for branding and marketing also. So there's another book by Seth Godin too. That's the Fortune Cookie Principle. The Fortune Cookie Principle, F-O-R-T-U-N-E. Yeah, the Fortune Cookie Principle. Explains storytelling, brand storytelling. It gives different, different areas, different ways, 20 different ways you can tell your stories, your brand stories. Trust me, you would enjoy it. I'm reading it. I'm still reading and I'm enjoying it right now. And a lot of books like that. So another book you need to learn about is Designing Brand Identity. I think this is majorly for designers anyway, but you can also check it out by Aina Willa. Aina Willa really gave a serious breakdown of how brand identity have been designed. So if you want to know a lot of things about you, your branding, then you need to check out that book. It's very, very essential for you and to do a lot of things. So there are a lot of books out there for branding, how great brandings, what great brands do. That's another book again, What Great Brands Do. You can check it out on Google and download them. Some are free and some are on Amazon.
Perfect, perfect, perfect. Thank you so much. So I'm done with my questions. Okay. So I'm super duper happy that, you took time from your busy schedule and then you could come here. I'm super duper happy. So thank you so much again. So I'm done my questions. So if you would like to tell something about the show or something else, you can go ahead and then the audience can shoot their questions.
Okay. Yeah. So, I really would love that. Firstly, I would like to say that I'm so happy to be on this show. And I was so elated. I was so happy when I got the invite to come over here. So, guys, I want you guys to keep watching the Nida Fido show. And really, she's amazing. She's so amazing. She has been my friend. And no, trust me, we've been talking almost every day. And she's really, really amazing. And I'm really telling you right now that you won't miss, that whole lot of values are coming for you on this show. I really want you to keep watching this. And really, trust me, I'm very sure today you got values. I you can't doubt the fact that you got values today. So I really, really love Nida and I love her show. I love what she does. And I want you to keep doing what you're doing. And thank you very much for having me once again on the show.
Thank you so much. I'm so happy. I'm glad. We have a question here. So we have a question from Shaswat telling that branding or marketing, which one should a startup business focus more?
Yeah, branding comes first before marketing. Branding comes first before marketing. Yes, so you need branding. Both of them work hand in hand with each other. So the marketing is what sells it out. I don't know what I'm saying now. The marketing is what exposes your brand. So branding is a process. So branding comes first before marketing. And mind you, branding is a process. Are you getting what I'm trying to say now? So the marketing, So the branding process is very, very essential. So the marketing is what sells you out. I guess now the branding is the process of communicating your brand to the people. Do you understand what I'm trying to say now?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. So you must ensure that you brand first before marketing. To ensure that your branding is well carried out. So because it's a process, and like I always say, you can't brand in few weeks. You can't brand in few days. It takes time to brand. So as you consistently brand, they can go alongside each other, because at different stages, at different situations, you keep branding. I don't know if you got a chance now. You keep branding. You know, there are processes whereby you need to start renewing your brand in different dimensions, because people need to perceive your business in different ways. Are you got a chance now? Actually, they need to perceive your business rightly. So, but, you know, in different dimensions, for example, 2020 was a period for people to communicate their brand in different dimension. Why? Because you can't brand like you branded 2019 in 2020, because it might not work. So you need to understand the situation of the things on ground and brand correctly. I don't know if you got what I'm trying to say now. So branding comes first before marketing, and at the same time, sometimes they go hand in hand with each other. All right.
Okay. So I have pinned a question over here. Can you hear me? I have pinned a question here. What YouTube channel would you recommend to learn design?
Okay. Yeah, I would love to say that on designs, you need to check out Chris Dew's. No, there are a lot of Chris Dew's YouTube channel. Chris Dew has a whole lot of things you need to see. So by the time you check Chris Dew's, there are a lot of other designers that comes, you know, underneath. You see a lot of them that really, you know, are recommended for you as a designer. You can start with them. So these guys are the professionals that you need to really, you know, look out for on YouTube. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of designs, you know, YouTube channels on YouTube that you can actually, but Chris Dew for me is someone that can really, really tell you right now. So because I can't remember some names. I don't register their names on my head. But I just go there, I get what I need to get, and that's it.
Okay. So yeah, thank you so much, my dear, for coming, taking time from your busy schedule. So yeah, we can
thank
end
you very
right
much.
Now. Yeah, so I'm super duper happy to collaborate with you, and
thank
I
you
would
very
love
much.
To do more sessions with you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, so thank you. Bye bye. Have a good day.
All right, guys. Thank you.
Bye bye.